Hit a quick little tech deck trick for the video. Yo, what's going on, everybody? My name is Manny Balls, and I'm finally back with another video. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about Killstation. So Killstation is an artist that I've really liked for quite some time, and I feel like he pulls numbers. Like, if you watch his videos and stuff, he pulls mad numbers, but I just don't think he's talked about nearly as much as he should be, and I don't see any interviews or any videos on him, so I figured I'd be the first one to make a video about Killstation. Find me a new made grave. So Killstation is a very talented artist. He's a singer and producer from California. His real name is Nolan Santana. So he says that he's been making music for as long as he can remember, and that he started recording songs at the age of 10. He says he started playing guitar at the age of 8 or 9. And one thing that I think is really interesting is that he used to make dubstep remixes under the name Killstation. That's kind of where he got his name, and he's been running with that for the rest of his career. So as for his music style, Killstation says that he used to listen to a lot of bands as a kid, such as Nine Inch Nails, My Chemical Romance, Korn, and a bunch of other bands that kind of influence his style as it is today. And probably my favorite thing about Killstation, other than his singing, is that he produces all of his own music. I don't think if you go on his SoundCloud there's a single song that doesn't say Proud Killstation, which I think is super dope, and I think that that needs a lot more attention. So I'd personally describe his musical style as a combo of kind of rocks with metal, with some emo rap, with some scream rap and alternative mixed in there. It's kind of hard to describe. You kind of just have to listen to it and figure out for yourself. He doesn't really rap anymore. He used to rap a lot more. He used to do a lot more of the yelling rap as well, but he doesn't really do that anymore. It's pretty much entirely singing. His production style is very bass oriented, with a lot of really heavy guitar riffs throughout the entire song, which I really enjoy. He has some very big emo vibes in his music as well, and I'll get more to that later. And his music is typically classified under the rock section on music and streaming services. Everything never could be like it was. I forgot, never thought living life without love was so dark and so really been So Killstation has collabed with a lot of different artists and a lot of big name artists as well. He used to be a frequent collaborator and friend of Lil Peep, Ghostmain, and Brennan Savage, and the four of them were pretty good friends back in the day. And he also gets compared to Lil Peep all the time, and every single comment is like, yo, you sound like Lil Peep, which is interesting to me because, like, I'm not gonna deny that he doesn't sound a little bit like Lil Peep, but his music's very different and I personally prefer it more. And I think it's also possible that at one point he was in Schema Posse, which was a group that was full of a ton of people in the underground in the emo community, and it had people like Lil Peep and Ghostmain in it, but it didn't really explicitly say he was in it. And he also has another controversy regarding Peep, because right now he's dating Peep's ex-girlfriend. And people are saying it's really disrespectful for him to date his girlfriend after he's passed. If I had to guess, if you're such good friends with a person, you're not gonna just for no reason date their ex after they pass. So I'm pretty sure there's a lot more to it that the public doesn't know. So I think it's kind of lame that there's a bunch of keyboard warriors saying, oh, you're such a bad person. And Killstation is also a member of Members Only. I'm not sure how active Members Only is as a collective, if it is anymore. However, he was a member when it was thriving and very popular. That's how I first ever found Killstation, was on his collab with X Slipknot. However, his voice kind of was ear piercing the way it was mixed on that song, so it wasn't my favorite. However, I eventually heard him on the song Limbo, and that was when I decided I really liked Killstation because he carried that song. The wind blows through the window at the house of a dead man. He was also on songs such as Snow, Rebirth, and a lot of other songs with X. He still also works and is friends with Craig Zen, who is also a member of Members Only. So he does have some connections that way as well. So Killstation's been dropping music for quite some time. The oldest song you can find on his SoundCloud is 5 years old. However, the earliest song you can find anywhere is from 2014, and it's called Leave You Guessing. As I mentioned earlier, he started making music when he was 10, and I believe he's like 24 now, so he's been doing music for like 14 years. He has 11 solo projects out right now, which consist of a bunch of mixtapes, EPs, and his debut album, which is called The Two of Us Are Dying. That album is what made me really enjoy Killstation's music. I think a lot of his music before that wasn't always terrible, but I think a lot of it just wasn't mixed as well as it could have been, or wasn't produced as well as it could have been. But on his recent album, his quality has gone up so much that I just really, really, really enjoy his music, and I'm really excited to see what he has coming next. With all the improvement in his music, you can definitely see a lot of promise with Killstation. He's a super talented artist. He's really good for the emo vibes. He has some really great rock songs, and his production, I think, stands out amongst all other emo rock type of production. It's really interesting the way he incorporates different types of bass and kind of has like the punch kick in later through the song, has really like really good build-ups in his music. I think the way he formats his songs is very excellent. He has songs like Excelsior, Sarcoma, and other songs that I really, really enjoy that I think you guys should check out. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I've been gone for a while. I'm trying to come back. We're working on it. We got stuff going on, but we're back. Thank you guys for staying around, listening and watching the videos. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you liked, make sure to leave a like. If you really enjoyed, make sure to drop a sub down below. Other than that, it's been Matty Balls, and I'll see you guys next time.